in most cases. So we were able to show that although it didn't fit the black letter of the law, Cycle Bar belonged in this location on Franklin Avenue in Garden City because it met the spirit and intent of the statute. They didn't want an office on the first floor. This made sense. And what was added to that was let's keep business local, because if I've got to go to Roslyn or Port Washington for a facility like this, maybe I'll have my salad or my shake or even a slice of pizza if I got a good workout in that area. And if I need a new pair of workout clothes, sweatpants, I'll buy it in that area. And maybe I'll drop my dry cleaning off up there because I'm going to be back next week. So it's keeping business local.
Craig, we want to find out more about the world of zoning, but at this point in the show, we want to take a brief break from my hometown on 90.3, the voice of Nassau Community College. Our guest today is attorney Craig Biscone from Garden City, who practices real estate and zoning matters. Stay with us. We'll be right back for part two on zoning with Craig Biscone.
I'm a college student and could use advice about my student loan.
I had to leave school and go to work. Now I have to pay back student loans for a degree I don't have. Fortunately, I found assistance.
Back in college, I figured they wouldn't lend me more than I could easily pay back. Boy, was I wrong. Thankfully, I got the help I needed to pay back my loan in full.
Sound familiar? The good news is that student loan repayment options are available. We're the NFCC, the National Foundation for Credit Counseling, a nonprofit organization with member offices nationwide that provide comprehensive financial reviews and student loan counseling. NFCC-certified consumer credit counselors provide one-on-one financial counseling and can help you evaluate options for making student loan payments, reducing interest, debt consolidation, or even loan rehabilitation. Call 877-406-6322 or visit us online at studentloanhelp.org.
My hometown is made possible by Herald Community Newspapers. For more local news, visit liherald.com. Got a story to tell? Call 516-569-4000. WHPC.
And now we return to My Hometown.
We're back on My Hometown. I'm your host, Bill Horan, along with Nassau Community College student Zach Turkel on WHPC 90.3, the voice of Nassau Community College. Our guest today is attorney Craig Biscone from Garden City, who practices in the field of real estate and zoning matters. Craig, before the break, we cut you off and you were explaining your typical day. You didn't even get up to lunch yet, so come on, fill us in on the rest of it.
Goodness. Yeah. Well, Zach had asked me to go through my typical day as a zoning attorney from when the client first comes in, and I said, first we have to analyze it. Is it reasonable? Is it something likely to be granted, or maybe we should modify it?
Now, that's about 10 o'clock in the morning. Now you're ready to go to the country club for the three-hour lunch, couple of martinis.
Is that really all you care about, Bill?
In a different
yeah,
life.
Kind of.
But no, seriously, then I would research the code provisions that are applicable. I would plan with the owner and co-professionals because it's teamwork, architect, traffic engineer, and whatnot. Then I prepare. I start out with a very long outline, and I pare it down to just the salient facts, and I never read to the board, because that'll put them to sleep. That's when you lose them.
He must be a very good quiet reader, but if you have children, you want to hire him. If he reads to the children, he'll read the zoning code. They'll go right to sleep.
I'm certain.
Now, Craig, are most of your matters in the residential field or the commercial field?
Well, much like my transactional real estate practice, there are more houses than commercial buildings. So on a sheer volume basis, residential, but the commercial certainly present greater challenges, like use variances to show there's no other economic use for the property. But it's definitely a mix, and I enjoy them, I'll say equally, because there's nothing like having a kid see you on the soccer field and saying, thanks for my new bedroom or the new man cave.
And it better be that you got him the new bedroom or man cave, because if he's out in the garage, you're going to be hiding on that soccer field.
Exactly.
Zach?
So, Craig, is there a type of issue that comes up on a regular basis?
With commercial properties, parking seems to be the banner issue. Mm-hmm. As you can imagine, a warehouse would have a much more lenient parking requirement per square foot than, say, a movie theater. But if I have a movie theater that they want to put in the middle of a cluster of office buildings, I will use the alternative use theory. Well, this movie theater only shows at nights and on weekends. So when all the office workers leave, The parking lot will be empty. Those are our hours of operation. And on the weekends, they're playing golf or doing whatever they do. They're not in the office. Be careful with that, though, because it's got to be genuine. The board may impose a condition for no hours of operation during business hours for the movie theater. So, yeah, parking is one big one. And with typical homeowners, lot coverage, areas have been upzoned. The 6,000 square foot lot was standard, like in a Levitt community, cookie cutter houses on cookie cutter lots. And what's happened is a lot of these areas have been upzoned. So now you're on a 6,000 square foot lot, and it's now 10,000 square foot zoning, and you've got to comply with the current regulations. So lot coverage and setbacks definitely kick in.
Craig, once again, at this point in the show, if someone didn't hear it originally, tell us where Craig Biscone practices, where your office is, and how could someone get in touch with you if they're finding this is applicable to their life?
Well, the office is about a mile from my house at 1399 Franklin Avenue in Garden City, Suite 202. My phone number at the office is 516-248-4444. I'm usually in, but if not, my paralegals, Kathy and Melissa, would be happy to take information and get you in touch with me.
And as our listeners can tell, this is someone who knows what they're talking about. So if you do have a zoning problem or a real estate problem, give him a call and see what's happening in his office. Now, suppose I don't like the outcome, or I feel that one of the members of the board just didn't like me. They thought I had funny ears, I'm old, I'm bald, whatever. And can a zoning decision be appealed, and how does that go about?
Well, since you're wearing headphones, I can't see your ears, Bill, but yes, for the aggrieved party, there is a mechanism called an Article 78 proceeding. So if the applicant is denied, or if one of the objectants is upset that the application gets granted, you know, the next door neighbor who doesn't want to see the house expanded as requested, you would file an Article 78 proceeding with the Supreme Court in the county in New York in which the property is situated. You have 30 days from the filing of the notice of decision with the town or village clerk or city clerk, as the case may be, in order to commence your action. The difficulty you'll face is that very often the decisions are not available. You'll file your FOIL request, Freedom of Information Law, and the decision's not ready yet. So what you can do to preserve your rights as an aggrieved party is file a notice of appeal within that 30 days, and then you're golden. Once you get the decision, you can attack it with an affirmation on the merits. I caution you, though, the courts almost take a laissez-faire position. They say to the zoning boards, you know your area better than we do. So unless that decision is really arbitrary, capricious, against the weight of the evidence, it's probably going to be upheld.
Zach, I want to point out to you, now you know he's a real lawyer.
Mm-hmm.
If a lawyer doesn't use arbitrary and capricious every half hour,
yeah,
they're probably not real. Just a life lesson. You're a young student here at Nassau. I want you to know that. Key lawyer words, arbitrary and capricious.
All right. I think I got it.
Go ahead. You had something.
Yes. So, Craig, these are some interesting questions that I really want to ask you. So we'll start off with this one. What is a good day in your profession?
Well, I have one kid in college and one on the way to college, so a good day is when I get paid. In all seriousness,
his kids are on scholarship. They're smart. Don't worry about it. You don't have to pay him.
Thank goodness.
I think a good day is when I get a positive decision that's good for my client, the applicant, and doesn't hurt the community. It truly fits that balance of benefit versus detriment. I think that's really when I feel gratified that I've done some good.
Craig, we think of zoning as what you're telling us, as something to do with the real estate and the setback of the house. So it's not like a criminal case where you get the wild and woolly kind of matters. Is there any cases in your field that are really funny or something you can tell us without mentioning any names?
Oh, goodness. Yeah. A number of years ago, we had a subdivision. It was a Cape Cod house on a couple of acres, and there was a horseshoe development around it built in the 50s. So main road, little house, big lot. And the owner wanted to develop it into what they call flag lots, one house behind the other with a shared driveway. And I made my presentation. It was really good and reasonable. And in the middle of my presentation, one of the adjoining owners got up and screamed, "That's our green belt!"
What's a green belt? Now,
yeah.
I haven't tell her what it is.
A green belt.
Big open space, a green belt, the park.
Okay.
Right? That's our park. That's our green belt. And I had to bite my inner cheeks to stop from laughing hard, but I couldn't let it go. So I said, "Mr. Chairman, even though that remark was out of turn, I'd like to address it. I have, for the record, a title search and a certified copy of the deed from the Nassau County Clerk's office. That is not the gentleman's green belt. It's my client's green belt. And by the way, each of the 60 homeowners that adjoin the property are on undersized lots that could not be built on today without relief from this board. The lots that we're proposing, the 7 or 8 lots, are double the size of any of their lots. I said, may I continue with my presentation regarding our green belt? I thought that was pretty
funny. You see, he comes very well prepared. He has the title work, everything right there. So someone comes up with the wrong excuse, he can kind of put them right back in his place.
Right, definitely. So, Craig, so since we talked about your good day in the profession and also some of your memorable cases, your funny cases, this is my next question. What were your most memorable cases?
My most memorable cases, they were not my most lucrative. In fact, they were my loss leaders, but were for a community development agency where we concentrated on a redevelopment program in a very blighted area. I'm talking boarded up houses and businesses, rampant unemployment, a lot of drug use. It was really scary. And through eminent domain, acquiring properties for a public good,
That's the definition of it. Is that what eminent domain is, acquiring properties for
government
public good?
Takes your property and gives you just compensation, okay, and then does something else, not for private use, but for the good of the community. In this case, affordable housing. People got to own their first houses through a lottery system with subsidy mortgages, community centers with vocational training. So here you had an area that was crime-ridden, graffiti-ridden, blighted. I'll drive through there 20 years later today and be really proud that I was a small part of the transformation of this area to have people thriving, employed, and owning their own homes. It was just a really wonderful thing. Intrinsic value was phenomenal.
Unfortunately, I guess that's the part of law that people really don't see, and it really does give lawyers a great feeling inside that they can take part in things like that, or just to make life better, whether it's for children, for aggrieved people, victims, and sometimes it's not the most notable and certainly not the most lucrative. But now, Zach, something I'm going to expose today. You know, we like to embarrass our guests,
and this is
my opportunity. Craig, I understand you have a bit of a secret life that comes out at night, and I'm going to let you explain it so I don't get into any more trouble. You have kind of an alternate career, shall we say?
An alternate career? Well, yeah. Every year I would run the Tunnel to Tower run for Steven Siller, a firefighter who ran through the Brooklyn Battery Tunnel off shift and perished at 9/11. Mm-hmm. And I would do this with my boys, and it was a great way to give back and donate. And it was a fun event, too, despite the sad circumstances. And we would take... first year it was one bus, then we had a dozen buses heading towards Brooklyn Battery Tunnel to run through. And I met a lovely lady who happened to be a booking agent for a casino in Atlantic City, and she said, you're really funny. You should take this class at Stand Up University. And it was 3 phenomenal comedians, and I took the 7-week class and had a lot of fun with it, wrote my own comedy, and can't tell you why, but people started to hire me to do shows in New York City and Long Island, and sometimes I would back up real comedians, serious comedians.
I've seen your act, and I really enjoy it. Before we wrap up, I just want to let our guests listeners know that if you like what you're hearing from Craig Biscone today, his name is spelled B-I-S-C-O-N-E. He's an attorney in Garden City right on Franklin Avenue. Is it 1399?
1399 Franklin Avenue, 516-248-4444.
Took my line away. Easy enough to remember. Give him a call, let him solve your problems for you, and he'll even tell you a few jokes. We want to thank Craig for being with us and for being a guest on My Hometown. Thanks for listening. On behalf of Bill Horan and Zach Turkell, you've been listening to My Hometown.